Hello everyone, I am Ashna Khan and welcome to my channel. Today I am going to discuss this wonderful movie called My Happy Family, and it is available on Netflix. 2017 Georgian movie, which is available with English subtitles as well as English dubbing, so you don't have to read the subtitles, you can directly see the movie in English. So without further delay, let's dive right into it and discover why this film has been critically acclaimed all over the world. My Happy Family is the story of Manana. She's the central character of the movie. She's 50 plus, 50 plus old lady, and she wants to live life alone. So on her 50th birthday, she decides to break the news to her family and tell them that she wants to live alone in a flat. And this really shocks the whole family because they have this normal, life, family life that is been going on. So you see, they have two sons, one daughter. The girl's parents also live with them, and the husband, and it is a picture perfect family. But once you dwell deep into the story, you understand how fractured the whole family equation is. So Manana discovers, as she lives alone, the joy of living alone, the little moments that make her happy. She has been this down in the dumps, living her own life for others, and this is the first time in her life where she is living for herself. She has been sucked into this domestic life, where she is just tending to the people around her, and here we discover that she is living the life for her own self. So through these small scenes, we see that how she enjoys her life, making the food she likes to eat, sitting in the balcony just watching the nature, also learning to playing guitar whenever she feels like, reconnecting with her old friends in a reunion, and also just being herself, decorating the place as she wants. These are the little things that had been missing in her life. Maybe for others these things will be very small things, but for her these things really define who she is. So as she lives alone, she discovers many secrets. For example, her husband is having an affair with another lady. He also has a secret child with her. So the seemingly happy family is actually a fractured one. You see that everyone has their issues. When the son brings home the pregnant girlfriend, everyone is actually living a life, and she is the one who had been sacrificing herself. You also see the picture of her elder brother, who always tries to be bossy with her life, and as long as she's living in these domestic realms, he's happy with her. But the moment she decides to live life on her own terms, he is having lots of problems with that. He tries to let few people keep an eye on her, and that is whatever he thinks that it is a protective thing, but she feels that it is the defying of her private life. And so these little things that make this movie a masterpiece. So the good and the bad, if we discuss, there are many goods. This movie is actually the story of every housewife or every woman who has been caught in domestic life, stifling and suffocating, sacrificing her own comfort and will for the life, for the benefit of others. So the burden of sacrifice is actually put on the woman, and we forget to live our own life on our own terms. So when she makes this decision, we see how important it was to her and how important it can be for every woman around the globe. And this also has the feminist angle to it. Suppose when you see the same decision, if her husband Russo makes, then it is okay, but if she makes this decision, then she being a woman, she's being faced with a lot of questions. Even her own parents and her own brother question this decision and want her to drop the decision and and just live the way she has been living till now. So these are the little moments I found that every woman will be able to see themselves in the character of Manana, and in the little happiness, joy moments which she has in her life alone, those are amazing. The camera has done, the direction has done a great work in making us go into right into the family. We feel that we are just sitting there, a part of the party or a part of the discussion. That's how the camera angles take us to. We also feel a little bit claustrophobic when we see Manana being suffocated in this societal barriers which she is being, where she has to entertain the guests and smile when she doesn't want to and be in the crowd when she doesn't want to. So these are the little things that make this movie, this character is spectacular. I think she is going to inspire very women around the world to maybe not take such a drastic step, but to choose to take out some time for themselves in their life, so that at the end they don't feel this unsatisfaction or they don't feel this need to be on their own. The bad thing, I didn't find anything bad. Maybe the ending will not satisfy many people, and the slow pace can test your patience sometime. But if you're going with the flow of the story, I think it will work for you. So this is not the edge of the seat thriller where you will be finding lots and lots to explore. But here is, you are exploring the world through the eyes of the main character, and I really like it. So recommended? Yes, obviously recommended. I loved the movie. Being a woman, I saw myself in the character. I just loved when she was living her life alone, and I smiled when she was smiling. I was feeling the emotions which she was going through. So I'll highly recommend it if you want to watch an offbeat, slow burn movie. And this is easily available on Netflix. Don't miss it, guys. Thank you so much for your time. Thank you for visiting my channel. I'll be back with many more such reviews. Please subscribe to my channel, like the video and share if you like it. And also comment if you have seen this movie or any such movie, and what was your experience watching this movie. So I would recommend My Happy Family on Netflix. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for watching.